So we're approaching the end of this video series, and we're talking about how the resources are shared. So one common pattern we've seen is that it's more efficient to share resources than to dedicate them for everyone. So for example, instead of buying everyone a really fancy kitchen that can do everything they need, we buy everyone a good kitchen for day-to-day use, and then we get a really nice shared kitchen when people have really big events that need to be done. Actually, that's like my friend's apartment building. So they have a big shared commercial kitchen in the bottom, which can be used for big events and anyone can reserve it. But anyway, so the thing in computer clusters that does this is usually called Slurm. Slurm is a piece of open source software. It stands for Simple Linux Utility for Resource Management, although these days it's not that simple because stuff gets more complex over time. So it's basically the dominant software in computer clusters these days and does the allocation of things. So the first thing to realize is that whenever we submit things, we aren't sitting there ourselves in a queue waiting for things to become available. We write up the orders, so basically what we need, and then we put it into a script, and then we submit this. And it can run sometime when we're not there watching it. So we can have tens, hundreds, thousands of things waiting in the queue to run without us needing to explicitly manage every one of them. Okay, so the things Slurm reserves are not just CPUs, but it can reserve memory, CPUs, GPUs, disk space for temporary scratch work, and so on. And most important is the time, so how long the reservation is for. So some of the jargon here. So job is the thing we submit and runs. Slurm is the resource allocator, as I said. And there's the priority, which is an order of, what sequence things will run. The requests are what the batch job is asking for. So the first thing that Slurm does is it takes all of the requested jobs in the queue and sorts them in some order. And that's what I've done here. So this is some order. It will take and look at the jobs. So we see this job request 2 CPUs for 3 hours. So the next thing it does is it starts allocating these jobs into their places. So here I am, I'm placing them somewhere where it fits. So we can schedule these first, and there's a hole here which doesn't fit with this next job, and so on. So it goes to some amount of time into the future and makes the plan. So of course, only the stuff here starts running, so the stuff that's later can be rescheduled if needed in order to optimize the efficiency some. Okay, and then after it goes as far in the future as it wants to, it can notice there's some holes here. So it starts looking at the job. So this doesn't fit, this doesn't fit. But this job in the future, even though it's lower priority, can take advantage of this little hole right here. And thus we can use our resources better. So sometimes a lower priority job can run sooner than you would expect if it's small. Okay, this is called backfilling. So when it takes something and fills in the little holes that are here. Okay. Another thing to point out is heterogeneous jobs. So this piece here requests 2 CPUs for 1 hour, 1 CPU for 2 hours, and 2 CPUs for 1 more hour. So this doesn't work with Slurm. This isn't how it works. There is something called heterogeneous jobs, but it's not this here. So oftentimes in modern workloads, this happens. Like there might be a lot of CPUs needed for some initial data processing. Well, I guess really this happens more often with memory than CPU, but anyway, close enough. Modern data science workloads don't always fit in these nice rectangular boxes like we see here, and we get this. So it doesn't work well with Slurm. So either you have wasted resources or you need to cut it into different pieces and then run them as dependent jobs. Something to keep in mind. Okay, so what are some problems? So when you have really big jobs, like this here, it's really hard to schedule them. It might have to go far into the future, and it needs to reserve a lot of different CPUs at the same time for a while, especially if it's a wide job. So big jobs don't run very fast, or don't run very soon. So the smaller you can make jobs, the better. So when you take that to a limit, like we discussed before, you have array jobs. So array jobs is like this. So here I have a bunch of 1x1 squares, and they are, we have a big stack of them. And Slurm, the scheduler, knows these all go in the same sequence. So first off, it takes less memory and time for Slurm to do the processing of these. So it's good for the system itself. Second, since they're so small, they can fit in all of these little holes. So let's imagine I didn't have this job. I could start backfilling here. Oops. And then if there were holes wherever else, I could start filling them in. And there's still flexibility to fit in the big jobs there. So yeah, array jobs, pretty good. Both for you, with your scanning parameter space, or just running a lot of stuff that's embarrassingly parallel. The disadvantage is that there's a little bit more overhead when starting up. So you don't want array jobs to be really short, because that's basically wasting the computer time. Jobs are less efficient when they're short, because it takes longer to start them running and all that. On our cluster, we say an hour is a good time to target, but if it's more than, say, 15 minutes, it's usually okay. So another thing people will often ask is, when do my job run? And that's a good question. So Slurm will give you an estimate of when it will start running, but it's not accurate. So at any time, some job that is a higher priority can come in and move all your other jobs to be later, or things can come, or some of these jobs can finish sooner. So in this nice diagram I have here, everything is in a certain size unit. Everything takes an hour. But in reality, all these jobs can possibly end earlier and be shorter. I mean, they can be scheduled for shorter times also. And then if something gets done earlier, these move earlier, and so on. New holes may appear, all kinds of things can happen. So in summary, you're the manager here. So you're not sitting around and waiting for resources and running something, but instead you are the one that has to make the programs, decide what resources it needs, create the job, submit it to Slurm, and in return, you can get all of these resources and something that will manage the time for you. So you don't have to go and explicitly program things yourself. And it's pretty cool. It's a different kind of job than what you're used to. But most of us in my team like it, of course, because it's what we do professionally. Whether you like it or not, hopefully this has gotten you started, and you can get your work done as quickly as possible. If you need help, remember, come and ask us. And with that being said, thanks a lot. Bye.